Christ is risen. In truth, he is risen. Russian, Christos voskres, vaistinu voskres. Greek, Christos anesti, alethos anesti. All praise be to Yeshua. Okay, someone wrote this comment, and by the way, this is the first installment in my series, False Brethren. Someone wrote this comment, quote, Father Peter Heers eloquently described the source of the problem. We are no longer choosing monks formed in monasteries as our bishops. That's the problem. When Greece gained independence in the 19th century, they looked to the West for inspiration. As part of their westernizing reforms, they created a class of, quote, non-monastic monastics, end quote. These were celibate priests who had never set foot in a monastery. They lived in the bishop's palace and went to university, where they were called, quote, archimandrites of theology, end quote. As a result, the hierarchy became effectively secularized and lost its ascetic and dogmatic ethos, end quote. And someone told me that Elpidophoros was made Metropolitan of Bursa in 2011 without having ever set foot in a monastery. He was then nominally made, quote, abbot, end quote, of Holy Trinity Monastery before becoming Archbishop of Goarch in 2019. At no point was he ever a monk in obedience to an elder. That's what I was told. I don't know if he ever stepped foot in a monastery. As head of the Greek Orthodox Church in America, Elpidophoros has tremendous influence and authority in the Orthodox society in America. He has used his position to promote BLM, support defrocked and suspended Russian clergy, encourage ecumenical conversations, confuse the faithful on the matter of abortion, and baptize the children of a, quote, homosexual couple, end quote. We wish he was an outlier, a rogue data point in Orthodox Christianity in America. Unfortunately, he is merely the culmination of an ever-growing movement with Orthodoxy in America towards liberalism, immorality, and ultimately heresy, end quote. By the way, that last paragraph was a quote from another website, which I linked to in the description. I'm going to conclude this video now. You know, I really want to encourage Archbishop Elpidophoros to repent, to convert to Orthodox Christianity. Be humble, obedient, set a good example of piety and faithfulness to Orthodox teaching and tradition. Okay, so folks, I personally believe that the Orthodox Church is being infiltrated by unbelievers. They've come in with an agenda. They don't believe in Orthodoxy. They have an agenda, I believe, and their agenda is to destroy the Orthodox Church, and that is not going to happen. Because the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, Yeshua, Jesus, protects his church.